The common misbehaviors of the youth include rampant chewing of marungi, smoking of opium, drinking alcohol, defilement, robberies and smuggling. The youth idle by the trading centers and roadsides, waylaying people, stealing their properties and animals without making efforts to work to earn a living. Umar Abui, the LC1 of Alima Kodrasel in Ombati Ward, Koboko North Division, is not pleased with the lazy attitude of the youth who need money without working, causing insecurity.
Our youth, they don't want to work. They want to drink, smoke opium, chew marungi, and they like prostitutes. And the use of prostitutes, they go with the money. So they are taking illegal lives of people. So that thing has scared the leaders who are working. Why are they not utilizing the money for sensitizing the community in the radios? And then leaving all other issues in the hands of LEC. Security is going out of hand. And how are we going to catch up?
Francis Senema, the LC1 chairman of Ambaru Village in Kuluba sub-county, calls for regular meetings and barazas to combat insecurity in the district.
The common case is mostly is defilement, land disputes, mostly common. These are common in Kuluba sub-county. And then drug abuse, like the young people, the youth are doing these practices of defilement, and they are the one defiling our small daughters.
In Gotu village in Media sub-county along Uganda-Congo border, Yuda Nyinya, the LC1 chairperson, is faced with cross-border crimes from the youth.
My village had some insecurity cases. One of them is chewing marungi, where people go to late hours at night. It causes some insecurity issues, fighting, theft, raps, and so on. You find that the raps are also there. Because for me, we're at the borderline. When this instance happens, some young men cross to Congo side. So it is a little bit difficult for us to overcome such issues. So I think up to now, when such incidents happen at our level, we normally come and sit down as a cabinet. After seeing that the trend of the offense has gone beyond, we normally refer these cases to the police.
Bosco Okurut, the regional human rights officer, Uganda Human Rights Commission, West Nile region, challenged the LCs to find solutions to problems other than abandoning their work.
If there was opportunity of changing villages, we would change. That's not the solution. You can change to the other village and you get the same issues there. Are you going to change to another village? Are you going to keep on running from one village to the other? No. Get a solution to the issue so that everybody benefits. You don't solve such issues by running away. You're running away from a problem. Whom do you want to come there where there's a problem?
Vincent Mugenyi, the deputy resident district commissioner Koboko, blames the insecurity to poor parenting.
Then, whom are you blaming? Koboko is sitting on the time bomb. These children are so energetic and you are aging. They are going to eat you like the way they eat my runji. They will just kill you alive when you are looking on your own children because you neglected your responsibilities. We are getting a number of problems from these youths. Everywhere they sit, they are planning to guard attack police and army. My dear, we have fire. We shall burn them all.
The Uganda Human Rights Commission trained over 40 LCs on human rights approach to service delivery, tasking them to report criminal cases to police. Robert Ariaka reporting for Urban News in Koboko District, West Nile region.